Hey girl, that's how I always start my videos on YouTube, or did, but this is for you people on Facebook. I'm gonna make a French bread pizza, just because I feel like making a video, and let's shoot one. It's easy to do. If you can get garlic bread at the store, do that. I don't have no garlic bread. I got some Liedenheimer French bread from Riesling's Bakery down in New Orleans. And this is the French bread, and I already used a piece off of it because it's only like that long, like a big fish. Right, good. And it is the French bread used on all po' boys at fine restaurants and mom and pop places here in Louisiana. How about that? This is simple, so simple. Just slop some sauce on it, crisp the bread up. Just top it with what the hell you want to top it with. It ain't no big deal. Let's get started. Oh boy. And this video goes out to a very special friend. Can't mention no names right now. But she knows who she is, right? What I got is some stewed tomatoes. And I'm gonna hit them with some oregano. If I can figure out how to open the damn thing. There we go. And some garlic powder, just for the hell of it. This pizza needs garlic, you better believe it. Y'all go over there. And we're gonna let this kind of stew, or re-stew, back in here. And by doing this in this cold liquid, that oregano will rehydrate, the dried oregano will. How did I know that, silly? Okay, so let this sit for about 5 minutes or so and worry it a little bit. I'm gonna put a little bit of really good balsamic vinegar in here too, because I want this. It'll almost be like a bruschetta, almost. But I ain't got no fresh basil. But I do have some whole milk mozzarella cheese. And that's not water mozzarella, it's different. It's a different haircut. So what I've got is some Mount Dora aged balsamic vinegar sent to me by a very, very special friend over in San Francisco. Thank you very much, Miss Mary. And she's come down anytime. Oh, you ought to smell this. It's sweet. It's like syrup. You can eat it on ice cream. I'm gonna put a little splash of that in there. And taste a little splash in my mouth. Because it is the most wonderful stuff. Oh my God. It's sweet. Doesn't taste like vinegar, kinda. If you don't know about it, just stay stupid. That's all I can tell you. We ain't building no nuclear submarines or space stations or any kind of crapola like that. We're just cooking down the bayou, boy. Oh my God. You make it the way you want it. You gonna have to eat it, not me. You know, that's what cooking's about. You get to make it your way. Are you paying attention, boy? Come on, come on. Look at me when I'm talking to you, damn it. So I got this loaf of bread, a piece of loaf, and I want to crisp it up. I could do it under the broiler, but I've got a, how you call it right here? A sandwich press. It's made by Breville. when people talk funny down in wherever in the hell they at, I don't know. Who cares? Put this back up. Go over there. Australia. And I got many fans down in Australia as well. And I want to give them a nice little shout out. Hello,
mates
in Australia. Now, so we got this French to bread butterfly, right?
Right.
Let's go ahead and put some butter. I've actually got a healthy butter. It's made with olive oil and sea salt and, okay, real butter, right. But it's not as bad for you. But what we're gonna put on here ain't so good for you, right? Kinda not. So the Russian bread, the Frenchy fried bread. Boy, I'm having fun today. I don't know why. Maybe because I'm in love. I don't know. Who knows? We're just having fun in the kitchen, and I love to cook, and I love to eat. That's our Cajun motto. We eat to live, and we love to eat. I'm serious. That is the motto of Cajun peoples. So hit this with some butter. Get out the way, Mr. Butter. Then hit it with some... how you call it? Some garlic powder, much as you can stand. Maybe some oregano flakes, dried oregano. Who cares? Like that. And I'm gonna put it in the Breville Sammy Press and let it get happy for a bit. And we go from there. Are you paying attention? Look at me when I'm talking to you. Boy. I say boy. Damn it, boy. Damn it, girl. My YouTube fans always love to hear me say that kind of stuff. And other things like, if you don't know, just stay stupid. This ain't Burger King. You can't have it your way. You take it my way, or you don't get the son of a bitch. And you like that shit. Hey, man, that's the way it is down the bayou. All right, our garlic bread is out, and it looks nice, real nice. Let's go ahead and put us some Trinity on here, just for fun. And we need to get a little bit of Earl on there. Just use some of this butter. It'll be just fine. Close him down. Let him get cooked. It ain't gonna take long. So let's assemble a pizza. Look, we got this, these marinated tomatoes. I'm finna say potatoes. And I actually poured a little bit of basil in here too. And we're just gonna put them on top of the pizza. Look, over here, boy, over here. Pay attention now. All right? So there we go, just put you some tomatoes on there, on that French bread, garlic Frenchy bread. Pour you a little bit of juice. Who cares? Work it out however you can. And let us, why are you tilting down on me or panning down? I see, your adjustment's too loose. Must be a loose woman. I know about them. Used to play in bands for years. Had many loose women. They were a lot of fun. But that don't last long.
Oh well.
That's why I'm single again. Cause it's a lot of fun, right?
Right.
All right, so we got that stuff on there. And let's get us some toppings. What kind of meat you want on it? I got pepperoni. I know that. And I also got some cheese. You want cheese on top or cheese on bottom? You making it, you're going to have to eat it. So figure it out for yourself. How about cheese on bottom and cheese on top? Nah. That's a twofer. A threefer. It's like a foursome. I don't know if you understand that. A lot of fun. Been there, done that. We'll do a twofer. That's foursome. No. Ha 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 ha. Bob having fun now. Now loves a pepperoni pizza. And don't get that goddamn turkey pepperoni. And I said got. I didn't say God. If you want to eat that shit, go for it. Don't come around here talking about no turkey nothing. Turkey bacon, turkey pepperoni. I don't want to hear about it. I'll run your ass out the house. I'm sorry. I don't roll like that. So load this sumbitch up with pepperoni or meat or whatever the hell you want to put on it. You're going to have to eat it like I already told you. And I'm going to go put this up under the brawler and get it happy. Really, really happy. And I'm going to be happy too after I eat it, because everything on there is mostly cooked. And I got some whole milk mozzarella. And I'm gonna put on top after I crisp up some of this pepperoni. And sample the piece, make sure it's still good. It is. Damn right. Salami goes great on a pizza. Too, by the way. Stick that under the broiler for just a minute. And let that start releasing some of its effervescent grease. And then top it with the cheese. Pop it back under the bra. Yum. Now, smoked provolone goes great on pizza. But I've got whole milk mozzarella. And this has been broiled. But just a bit to kind of crisp those peps up. And we just gonna put some of this freshly grated mozzarella on top. Whole milk or whole water. Water mozzarella does not work well on a pizza. It could be used, but you gotta be real careful with your temperatures because it gets really milky and runny. So just top it with as much cheese as you can stand. And then pop this back under the broiler until that cheese gets nice and bubbly. And you got you a little French bread pizza. How about that? What was so? This only took, I don't know, 10 minutes total to this point. Probably another 2 minutes under the brawler. That's all. After the first brawl, I added some more pepperoni with the cheese, and let's stick it back in there for a second brawl. Man, I already sampled a piece. Badass, dude. Look here. Yum. Later, Gator.
Now, if you ain't got no po' boy bread, you could use garlic toast, Texas toast, anything like that. Hoagie rolls, or hoggy rolls, or submarine rolls. Who cares? Try something.
This was fantastic. And easy to do. And as we say down in the bayou, le bon temps roulé. That means be happy, have a good time, party, do what you want to do. Here's a picture that kind of explains the way of life down the bayou. Till next time, bye, boy, girl.